You're looking at here the first video, the aftermath from inside the church when the explosion happened. We want to warn you, this may be difficult to watch. And there you're watching video of the ceremony for Palm Sunday services, and then obviously went to bars and black when that blast happened. Security officers are digging through the debris right now. It may be a little difficult to make out what you're seeing here, but concrete, wood, paper, it's all part of what's left behind after the bombing. CNN senior international correspondent and former Cairo bureau chief Ben Wedeman is live near the Turkish-Syrian border. Ben, what are you learning?
Yeah, Allison, we understand that this church, the Mar Girgis or St. George Church, was packed with more than 2,000 worshipers when a bomb went off, according to some reports, in the very front row of the church. So far, the death toll, 21, more than 50 injured, according to Egyptian state television. However, it's expected that that death toll will rise. And of course, this is not the first such attack on Christians. Back in December, there was an attack on a cathedral in Cairo that left more than 25 people dead. This past February, there were a series of attacks on Christians in and around the town of El Arish in the northern Sinai, which basically forced many of them, dozens of families, to flee to the Nile Delta as a result. Now, there's been rising tensions between the Christian community and Muslims within the country itself. And it's widely believed that the security services in Egypt simply have failed to protect the Christian minority in Egypt, which makes up almost 10% of the population.